I wish I could come, but cannot due to my boss and the leave plan that we set up. Hope you have a gala time. Enjoy whatever you can. Don't shaft each other and don't get into the competitive business. I mean, some guys can do Plummy better, some guys can do Golden Horn better. We all plus 50. Just relax. Bye.
Texas. I work here and my family's still in Canada, so they can't be here, and unfortunately I'm actually a bit under the weather today. I've got I did have some pneumonia, so I'm working from home, but I got a text from Bertie today with a photo of my dad, which was amazing, but I thought I should send you guys a small video just to tell you that I wish I could be there, and hope you guys have the best time. See you guys, bye. So just to continue, just to give you a little bit of background about myself and family, you know, I remarried my soulmate, and together we have 7 kids. Three from my previous, and we've got one adorable 5-year-old. She's almost six. Her name's Bella. So I wish, again, I could be there, but maybe at the 50th. All right, so watch this space. And last but not least, just the memories I've had of Mount Abu. They've been the best years. Yeah, it wasn't always good for me. I was only a little tiny runt, but you know, it sort of molded me into the person I am today. I don't know if some of you might remember this scar on my forehead at the final, you know, playing, I think it was playing St. John's with Neville swiping me across with the hockey stick. And, you know, I just stood there with blood coming down. I felt I was in the shower. But, yeah, that's a good mark of Abu, which I'll never get rid of. So, party on, guys.
Xavier's College to do science for 11 and 12, then did my computer science engineering degree out of the University of Pune, and thoroughly loved it there because I was a university student all by myself without my mom, etc., to oversee my partying habits. Anyway, after Pune, we immigrated to Canada, specifically Vancouver, and I've lived the rest of my life here. Love it. It's a beautiful city, a beautiful country. I did my MBA out of a local university, and then joined Accenture, being with them for nearly two decades as a consultant, traveling across North America, supposedly adding value, but it pays the bills. I did get married, now divorced, mainly due to medical complications. But the good news out of that is I have those two beautiful daughters that the pride of my life. They're 19 and 17. The older one is studying law in university, and the younger one is graduating over 12, grade 12 out here, and fingers crossed, gets back together to also take on a good university degree. For whatever reason, the kids out here don't listen to the parents, and so they absolutely against engineering and computer science, my background, because they think I sit all day in front of computers. But anyway, they do me proud because they are straight A students who also are good at the work they do. And they are well diversified in terms of playing sports, in terms of soccer, volleyball, gymnastics, etc. I do have a lot of family in Vancouver that have helped me through my tough times. The good news is I think I've come out on the other side, surviving. So I'm trying to enjoy the rest of my life and have very good positive memories, especially with my daughters, before they start to move on with their boyfriends and their lives. So I just came back from a great trip to Europe, which I recommend to anybody. Then hopefully one day we get to meet. I would prefer actually not meeting in Abu, because I have such positive memories of Abu that I fear going back may bring back some of the negative memories, like the washrooms, etc. So I prefer us meeting somewhere else. But life has its ways of getting us all to different areas, different spots, and different ways of interacting. So I assume one day we will all meet. Some people have dropped by Vancouver, and I've tried to show them the good sides of this woke country. But if you are ever here, you are welcome. Welcome to stay at my place. Welcome to have me take you to tour around the country, the countryside, and hopefully we do meet. My life lessons that I would suggest to all of y'all is family and health are more important than wealth. I am chasing the crypto dream, but I do know family and health matters most. So keep that in mind and be true to yourself. Stand up for what's right for you. If I'm very vocal on things I don't agree with. But family, health are the biggest things to keep in mind. And wish you all the best of luck. And again, welcome to Vancouver if you ever make it here. See you guys.
I haven't seen a rifle in your hand. Can you hear the drums, Fernando? Do you still recall the fateful night we crossed the Rio Grande? I can see it in your eyes, how proud you were to fight for freedom in this land. There was something in the air that night. The stars were bright, Fernando. They were shining there for you and me, for liberty, Fernando. Though we never thought that we could lose.
Hey guys, it's Cass. Happy 40th. I just wanted to quickly introduce the rest of the fam here. First of all, I'll start off with Aiden. And that's Abby
and Jada,
and last but not least,
Jaxie.
That's Jax right there.
Okay, I just want to say I'm kind of disappointed that I'm not there, but at the same time I know you guys are gonna kill it. Together we stand, St. Mary's loyal men. Those words just resound in my heart, in my breathing, in my brain. Every time I chat with you guys, I think about all the great memories. So I just want to say, have fun. It's been a blast, and hopefully one day I'll make it out there to see all my best friends. And yeah, guys, this is what it's all about. Take care. Hey guys, me again. I just want to say, in terms of some of the favorite things over there for me was walks. Obviously, the sports was big for me. I kind of really was serious about sports, and you can tell right now I'm looking at actually quitting my career as a quality engineer in the automotive industry,
and going into full-time coaching at an independent organization in New Jersey, in the USA, starting in December. I'll still be with the University of Toronto, where I currently coach, and with the Canadian women's national team. My family, as you can tell, are growing. We just purchased a new home in the Niagara region, and that's where we are today. We're actually at a vineyard, having a glass of wine on behalf of all of you on this 40th anniversary. So, guys, I just want to say all the best, and hope to see you soon. Bye. You thought of me, or have you completely erased me from your memory? I often think about where I went wrong. The more I do, the less I know. But I know I have a fickle heart and a bitterness and a wandering eye and heaviness in my head. But don't you remember?
And the thing that came to mind that I used to do very often was I came, I saw, and I conquered. As was said by Alexander the Great. And we used to just choose a week for that evening to find. And we were busy chit-chatting all the way up the mount. And before we knew it, we reached the top. Way back, way down, rather, there was no talk. It was just sprint down as soon as we can, and then continue the conversation on your way back to school.
clear creeks and cool mountain mornings, honest work out in the field, cornbread in my mama's kitchen, daddy saying grace before the meal. Family ties run deep in this land, and I'm never very far from what I am. I was born country, and that's what I'll always be. Like the rivers and the woodlands, wild and free. I got 100 years of down home running through my blood. I was born country, and this country's what I love. And you here beside me, crickets serenading in the yard. What more could two people ask for, laying here in love beneath the stars? Now this is where I want to raise my kids, just the way my mom and daddy did. I was born country, and that's what I'll always be. Like the rivers and the woodlands, wild and free. I got 100 years of down home running through my blood. I was born country, and this country's what I love. I was born country, and that's what I'll always be. Like the rivers and the woodlands, wild and free. I got 100 years of down home running through my blood. I was born country, and this country's what I love. I was born country,
my sweet little Alice blue gown, when I first wandered down into town, I was both proud and shy as I felt every eye. But in every shop window I'd creep passing by, and in manner of fashion I'd frown, and the world seemed to smile all around. My sweet little Alice blue gown.
Thank you.
my sweet little Alice Blue Gal. When I first wandered down into town, I was both proud and shy as I felt every eye. But in every shop window I'd creep passing by, and in manner of fashion I'd frown, and the world seemed to smile all around. Till it wilted, I wore it, I'll always adore it, my sweet little Alice Blue Gown.
Thank you. got my hopes set high. That's why I came tonight. I need to see the truth. I need to see the light. I've got my hopes set high. That's why I came tonight. I need to see the truth. I need to see the light. And I can do my best and pray to the Father. But the one thing I ought to know by now, when it all comes down, when it all comes down, if there's anything good that happens in life, it's from Jesus.
Tell Nah, nah, honey, I'm good. I could have another, but I probably should not. I got somebody at home.
So I'm feeling a lot better from the pneumonia, and I thought I'd remind you guys of that night. It was one of the talent shows, I don't remember the year, but this is what I sang. She's wondering what clothes to wear. She puts on her makeup and brushes her long hair. And then she asks me, say yes, you look wonderful tonight. I'll skip one. I feel wonderful, 'cause I see the love light in your eyes. And the wonder of it all is that you just don't. Got an aching head, so I give her the car keys. She helps me to bed, and then I tell her, as I turn out the lights, I say, my darling, you were wonderful. Darling, you were wonderful tonight. Thank you very much.
Dominic! Appreciation of Glenfiddich, an old monk, and Kajufeni, now my favorite hand sanitizer, which is 99% alcohol. The only person who drinks more than me is this freaking Pacheco. He's in a constant delirium, thinking he can outbox me. So to him I say, Pacheco, stop drinking, man. Else you'll be crawling in the boxing ring even before I can land a single punch. Or worse, I'll need to let you lower yourself and fight with Andy. Up to my room, Dominic. Dom, let me just say, you're not gonna get a wink of sleep. It's gonna be one friggin' non-stop orgy. We're gonna be flying higher than your planes, man. See you soon, guys. Can't wait.